human rights are women's rights, and women's rights are...
Phenomenal woman. That's my mother and all your mother.
Women use to the very best of their ability.
Both men and women should feel free to be strong.
Woman's place is truly wherever she wants it to be.
This is Forgotten Voices, a women's history series. Though many recall Frances Perkins as the first woman to serve as a cabinet secretary, some may not realize that she was instrumental in helping create the New Deal. Frances Perkins attended Mount Holyoke College in the early 1900s, a time when it was unusual for women to seek a higher education. It was there where she took an economics course that would change her life. The class toured factories along the Connecticut River to observe working conditions. Perkins later said she was horrified at the work women and children were required to do and was dumbfounded that no laws regulated the number of hours they were permitted to work. Several years later, while completing her graduate studies, Perkins witnessed the infamous Triangle Shirtwaist Company fire in 1911 in New York City. Because the doors were locked in order to prevent employee theft, nearly 150 workers, many women, died in the fire. Perkins later proclaimed that as the day the New Deal was born. The tragic event would lead her to become the executive secretary for the Committee on Safety of the City of New York. During her career, Perkins worked with many politicians, at one point being selected as the first woman to serve on the New York State Industrial Commission. Later, newly elected New York Governor Franklin Roosevelt appointed Perkins to the State Department of Labor. After winning his U.S. presidency in 1933, FDR then made Perkins the U.S. Secretary of Labor. Not only was she the first woman elected to a presidential cabinet, but she held the position for 12 years. Longer than any other Secretary of Labor. During her term, Perkins was a key player in writing the New Deal. She reformed the work week for women from 54 to 48 hours, drafted the Fair Labor Standards Act, fought for Social Security, and championed for a minimum wage law. The only item she failed to pass was implementing national health insurance. Before she left her position, she had come to be known as the best man in the cabinet. Though Perkins gained notoriety as being the first woman appointed to a presidential cabinet, she left her mark on the U.S. government by creating a legacy, advocating for workers and women's rights. Forgotten Voices is a celebration of Women's History Month.